Sweeney from ODIN, coming to you from Twitchell's Air Park in Turner, Maine. You know, it occurred to me, last time we were doing some flying together, we were talking about the handheld readers, and we're in a pretty standard aircraft, a Hawker Beechcraft Bonanza. Well, today, I've been out flying on the water. I'm flying a float plane, which is very unusual. Most people don't get to see a float plane, and it's a specific use for lakes, rivers, even ocean-bound flying, so you can land just about anywhere there's a good patch of water. But it made me think there are some very specific RFID readers, particularly modules, that most people don't know much about. A lot of people tend to think of standard off-the-shelf fixed readers. Well, today in this episode of our video blog, after we watch a few takeoffs and landings on the water, we're going to go back to the ODIN lab and look at some of the modules out there and what you might use them for. So let's have a look at some water landings first.
When you least expect it, you'll be dodging cannonballs. I've seen too much not to stay in touch with a world made of love and luck. I got a big suspicion about ammunition. I never forget to duck. Come back.
Thanks for that, Patrick. Wow, that float plane did look pretty cool, but it's not nearly as cool as the exciting world of RFID hardware. This is William coming to you from ODIN Labs in Ashburn, Virginia, here to talk to you more about reader modules. And Patrick, you're right, when most people talk about RFID readers, they don't think about the most essential piece of RFID hardware. When most people think about readers themselves, they think about this. This is a Sirit 510 Infinity, your standard fixed reader, again inside a rugged enclosure. But the most essential piece of the RFID system lies inside this hardware, or inside this rugged enclosure, and that's the reader module itself. Here's an example of a reader module. This is one from MTI. As you can see, they're very small when compared to a fixed reader, something on the order of a fifth, a sixth, a seventh the size of an RFID fixed reader. What an RFID reader module is itself is the piece of hardware which is going to communicate with the RF waves. It's essentially a radio that's going to be able to transmit RF waves and then receive the backscatted RF waves from your RFID tags. What you lose in an RFID reader module solution when compared to a fixed reader is processing power. The Sirit Infinity 510, for example, has a variety of features that you can tweak and play with to control virtually every aspect of your RFID system. Reader modules don't have that. All they give you back is information in a very limited capacity. What you need for an RFID reader module is processing power, as I said, and you can get that in the form of an SBC, some sort of computer or processing board, network connections to connect a lot of these together and control them centrally, and power source, obviously. But once you have these units together, it's possible to create an RFID system for a lot cheaper than an RFID fixed reader solution. Fixed readers, of course, can cost thousands of dollars. An RFID reader module costs hundreds of dollars, $200 to $400 or so. So again, you can immediately see the cost savings, and even when those other factors are added in, you know, you can create a solution with a reader module for something on the order of half the cost of an RFID fixed reader solution. These kinds of modules have been used here at ODIN in our smart container system, some of our healthcare deployments, sort of diversify and spread out the actual RF collection hardware, and we centralize the data manipulation with a single a single SBC, which can be connected to a variety of reader modules. And if you were to load ODIN's Easy Edge onto your processing board, you have the ability to control a variety of different reader modules spread out through multiple sites in one centralized location. So again, you can see how scalable and powerful a reader module solution is and can become for, again, a lot less than a fixed reader solution. Reader modules have been employed in other solutions such as the Ford F-150, the Thing Magic, and we've got an example of it here. This is the Thing Magic Mercury 5E. They've recently moved on to the 6E, and this is connected to a power board, which is going to allow you to power the module. That was used in the truck bed of the Ford F-150. There are other solutions being used in healthcare fields. Really, in any kind of implementation where size and price is really a factor, if you have a skilled RF technician, you can create a very powerful and, again, scalable solution with just the reader module and some other processing boards. This has been William with ODIN, reminding you that if you have trouble processing your RFID solution, to go ahead and give us a call here 866-787-RFID. Thanks a lot.
The kind you want to toast. We were treetop flying, moving west along the coast. Then we landed in the water, just about my favorite thrill. When some asshole started firing as we taxied to Negril. About to lose my temper as I endeavor to explain. We had only come for chicken, we were not the ganja plane. Well, you should have seen their faces when they finally realized we were not some coked up cowboys sporting guns and alibis. Come back.